So is, did he rewrite the Lord's Prayer?
Well, you know, what I think he did, is called a transliteration. Many of the translations of the famous Sufi poet Rumi are not direct translations. They're transliterations where someone really seeks to enter the spirit of his poetry and express it in kind of from their own intuition. Many of the translations of the Tao Te Ching are written this way. So what I suspect, because Neil Douglas Klotz is a bit of a mystic, is that he was really entering the core message, the vibration, if you will, whatever you want to call it, of the Lord's Prayer, which he would read in the Aramaic, and this is his response to it from a deep sacred space, which is probably more useful. You know, many of us don't relate to the images of the traditional Lord's Prayer that we recite every week. But a lot of folks really resonate with his translation. I've heard this over and over and over again of how much they love this translation of the Lord's Prayer. It speaks to us in the language and imagery of today. And so in terms of our whole integral theory and the integral model that constrains us and leads us, it really brings the truths of our ancient tradition into a form that can be appreciated today.